And the second topic is, who is Jesus Christ? Today, our topic will be the Holy Spirit. It will complement the Holy Trinity. The name of our topic is the power of the Holy Spirit. This topic is divided into four parts. One is receiving the Holy Spirit. Second is, who is the Holy Spirit? Third is receiving the gifts of the Holy Spirit. And the fourth part is the Holy Spirit in the faithful. Introduction. Much of Christianity today looks feeble, lacking power. Nasabihin daw ay masyadong mahina, kulang sa lakas. This led Friedrich Nietzsche, a 19th century philosopher who started the God is dead philosophy, to say, Christian need to look more redeemed before I believe in the Redeemer. Sabi niya, mga Kristiyano ay dapat mas mukhang natubos bago siya maniwala sa manginibos. Meron siyang point, but how can this be changed? And of course, the first part is number one, receiving the Holy Spirit. A, the promise of the Christ. Number one, I will ask the Father and He will give you another paraclete or helper or consoler to be with you always. The Spirit of Truth, whom the world cannot accept since it neither sees Him nor recognizes Him. But you can recognize Him because He remains with you and will be with you. From John 14, verse 16 to 17. Number two, I will send down upon you the promise of my Father, remaining here in the city until you are clothed with the power from on high. From John 24, verse 49. Letter B, fulfillment of the promise. On Pentecost Day, ang siguro tingnan muna natin, no? Ibig sabihin ng Pentecost Day, it is a prominent Jewish feast in the calendar of the ancient Israel, celebrating the giving of the law on Sinai, yung pagbibigay kay Moses ng law, yun ang Pentecost. But on our modern days, it is the descent of the Holy Spirit. The apostles and some of the disciples gathered together in prayer, awaiting for the coming of the Holy Spirit. When suddenly a noise like a strong wind was heard and tongues of fire appeared and rested on each one present. So nakita natin siya yung mga apostles and disciples, nag-rest yung tongue of fire sa kanila. And all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in foreign tongues and boldly proclaimed the Spirit as the Spirit prompted them. From Acts of the Apostles 2:1-4. Our second topic is, who is the Holy Spirit? A. The Christian confession of faith that appeared in the Nicene Creed and is affirmed by all true Christians answered this question. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. Together they will worship and glorify. The Holy Spirit is God, co-eternal and co-equal to the Father and the Son. As the Bible makes a distinction between the Father and the Son, both being distinct persons, tingnan niyo, distinct persons sila, Father and the Son. The Holy Spirit also a distinct person. One God, three persons, co-equal of one nature and essence. This is the nature of the Trinity. So kung titingnan natin, no? Father is not the Son, Son is not the Holy Spirit is not the Father, but at the center is God. God is the Father, God is the Son, and God is the Holy Spirit, so that completes the Holy Trinity. So let it be. The Scripture understands the Holy Spirit as the creative power in all life. He animates all, binds us together, and guides all towards everlasting salvation. So tingnan natin, number one, creative power in all life. The Spirit of God was with the Father and the Son at the creation of the universe. Ibig sabihin, the Holy Spirit, at the beginning of time, kasama na. In Genesis 1, chapter 1, verse 2, the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of waters. Verse 26, God says, let us make man in our image according to our likeness. So this is the illustration of nung creation, the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the waters from Genesis. He animates all. Animates means, iba nakikita natin sa, napapagalan sa cartoons, animation yan. Kasi siya bang pinipigyan buhay niya, yung mga object, yung mga tao, yung mga living things. The Holy Spirit animates the church. The church is not the result of human will, of reflection, of man's abilities, or his capacity for organization. If this were the case, she would have passed out of existence a long time ago, just as all human things pass. She is rather the body of Christ animated by the Holy Spirit. From Pope Emeritus Benedict XVI. So siya nagbibigay ng buhay sa body of Christ. Number three, binds us together. And to all these qualities add love, which binds all things together in perfect unity. From the letter of St. Paul to Colossians. Number four, guides all together towards everlasting salvation. The Holy Spirit is the guarantee that we shall receive what God has promised His people. And this assures us that God will give complete freedom to those who are His. Again, another letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. He is active particularly in Jesus Christ, in His conception, baptism, public works, death and resurrection. So isay natin ito. Jesus' conception. The Holy Spirit will come to you and God's power will rest upon you. For this reason, the Holy Child will be called Son of God. From Luke 1:35. So tingnan natin illustration. As we see in the illustration, Angel Gabriel announces the coming birth of Jesus to the Virgin Mary. The scriptures inform us that her conception was accomplished through the medium of the Holy Spirit. It is as Angel Gabriel. In Jesus' baptism, I saw the Spirit come down like a dove from heaven and stay with us. From John 1:32. So again, this is another illustrations, picture of John the Baptist baptizing Lord Jesus Christ, and you will see the Holy Spirit in form of a dove descending upon Jesus. Jesus' public works. The Spirit of Lord is upon me, therefore He anointed me. From Luke 4:18. The way God anointed him with the Holy Spirit and power, he went about doing good works and healing all those who were in the grip of the devil and get what is him. So tingnan natin itong illustration nito. Ito yung isa sa mga public works ni Jesus na nag-heal siya ng isang tao na possessed with the devil. This is from Luke 36:46-47. And the third part of our topic is receiving the gifts of the Holy Spirit. A. Baptism is the sacrament of faith. B. After the outpouring of the Holy Spirit on Pentecost Day, Peter announced Jesus Christ crucified as Lord and Messiah. The hearers asked him what they were to do. Peter answered, you must reform and be baptized, each one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, that your sin may be forgiven, then you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. So sinasabi ni Peter dito, you must reform and be baptized, each one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, that your sin may be forgiven, then you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. So this gift, after he's sent to him, hindi na nasabi ko siya. This will be discussed thoroughly in the coming session tungkol dun sa life in the Holy Spirit. This text shows that from the very beginning, conversion to Jesus Christ was linked to baptism in His name. The sacrament of baptism has always been the entrance gate and the foundation of the whole Christian existence in the church. However, it is through the power of the Holy Spirit that we are baptized. So, titingnan natin dito, no? Kaya itong mga ito, the sacrament has been always been the entrance gate and foundation of the whole Christian existence in the church. So, kaya mga lady, binigyan ng God. Kaya, welcome sila sa Christian world. Kasi yun ang entrance gate sa ating Christianity. And it will be only happen through the power of the Holy Spirit. And number four, the Holy Spirit in the faithful. Not A, letter A. The Holy Spirit works in people. Number one, do you know, as Saint Paul, that you are God's temple and that God's Spirit dwells in you? Again, the first letter of Saint Paul to the Corinthians, chapter 3, 16. His warmth and love are directed to the church and each individual. The essential task of the Holy Spirit is sanctify and make each one happy. So, ulitin natin. His warmth, love are directed to the church and each individual. The essential task of the Holy Spirit is sanctify and make each one holy. And the Corinthians believers were exceedingly vile. Yung mga Corinthians ay very bad and immoral and weak. But they were washed, and they were sanctified, and they were justified in the name of Lord Jesus and the Spirit of God. Again, from the first letter of Saint Paul to the Corinthians. So nung ma-receive ng mga Corinthians, mga Corinto, taga-Corinto yung Holy Spirit, nahugasan sila, na-sanctify sila, and they were justified in the name of Lord Jesus Christ by the Spirit of God. Again, in Ezekiel 36:26-27, I will give you a new heart, a place, and place a new spirit within you, taken from your bodies, your stony hearts, and giving you a natural heart. I will put my spirit within you and make you live by my statutes, careful to observe my decree. Papalitan daw yung mga batong puso natin at papalitan ng natural puso. The Holy Spirit provides us with a new power to what is right and effect changes in our nature. Also bring us the presence of God so we can pray, hear His voice, and experience His intervention in our lives. So ito yung power ng Holy Spirit, ano? With a new power to do what is right and effect changes in our nature. He also brings us the presence of God so we can pray, hear His voice, and experience intervention in our daily lives. But when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, you will be filled with the power and you will be witness for me in Jerusalem, in all of Judea, Samaria, and the ends of the earth. Ito po yung nangyari kanina sa breakfast. Our share, Brother Steve, the Spirit of the Holy Spirit. So, he witnessed si Brother Steve ay naging witness kanina umaga sa Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit help us remember the Word of God. So, kung napapansin nyo, no, mostly all of us, before we read the Bible, we ask and pray the Holy Spirit to send upon us to give us the gift of understanding so we can maintindihan natin yung anong message ng Panginoon para sa atin as we read the Bible. The Helper, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything and make you remember all that I have told you. From John 14:36. The Holy Spirit intervenes in our lives. The Holy Spirit searches our hearts. He makes us know things we cannot think and help us to understand the Word of God. So yung sinasabi ko sa iyo kanina. Letter B, how the Holy Spirit transforms. A good example of changes that comes over people when they receive the Holy Spirit is the class of change of their daughters. Ang unang change sa kanila, the apostles returned to Jerusalem with great joy. They no longer despondent. Ibig sabihin, hindi na sila hopeless over the departure of Jesus. Obviously, they understand why he was leaving. So, nung hindi pa dumarating yung Holy Spirit sa mga apostles, as you read the Bible, napapanood natin sa pelikula, no? Ang mga apostles walang ginawa kung tago ng tago kasi takot sila. They were afraid that yung ginawa kay Jesus, gagawin din sa kanila ng mga Roman, ano, yung ginawa kay Jesus, natatakot sila po. That's why sila kung magkita, sa isang lugar lang, takot na takot sila. But when the Holy Spirit comes to them, naintindihan nila lahat, naintindihan nila, bigyan sila ng power to transform. The second change in the lives of the apostles was in their spiritual strength. After Pentecost, they were different people. They were no longer free, like a sheep without a shepherd. So, yung takot nila, siyempre leader nila na wala, di ba, crucified. Pero nung dumating ang Holy Spirit sa kanila, so naliwanagan sila. So nabago, na-transform yung kanilang buhay na. Kahit wala na yung leader nila, biligan sila ng power of the Holy Spirit to be transformed. And these are some of the example of the Holy Spirit, power of the Holy Spirit. It transforms, it points us to Jesus, it convicts our sins, it generates, intercedes for us, enlightens us, empowers us, sanctifies us, speaks to us, and gives gifts. Bibigyan tayo ng gifts of the Holy Spirit. To see the abrupt changes, the need to compare them before and after receiving the Holy Spirit. So, tingnan natin dito. When Jesus was arrested, Peter denied him 3 times. All other, with the exception of John, ran away and hid themselves. When Jesus was crucified, only John was present. The others were nowhere to be seen. When they had seen Jesus killed and were afraid to say fate would be theirs, they were a depressed group full of scientists, fear and doubts. So yung sinasabi sa inyo kanina na takot at takot sila. Hindi nila alam ang gagawin nila. Pwedeng ano natin yun. Hindi ba maaaring yung picture? This side, yung side na to. Hindi ba? Hindi yung maaaring. Actually, this picture na ito si Jesse na rest, andito si Peter. Hindi siya makatingin kay Jesus kasi takot at takot siya. Baka yung ginawa kay Jesus gawin din sa kanya. When they received the Holy Spirit, they started to boldly preach the good news to the large crowd, and they, at the very same day, 3,000 Jews were converted. Sabi nga nung outreach said natin, yung first year, yung conversion ng 3,000 people. As the disciples of Jesus were filled with the power of the Holy Spirit, they were transformed. Formerly timid Peter, and though si Peter na mahiya and patatakutin, stood up and delivered a brilliant sermon that so convicted 3,000 people of the need to get right with God as they asked to forgive them for breaking his laws and receive Jesus as their personal Savior. So, kung babalik tayo, kita natin dito sa Peter, kanina, no, yahiya siya. So, nung ma-receive ni Peter ang Holy Spirit, bigla siyang tumayo. Nag-preach siya na at that preach, ang dami na convert, 3,000 people na convert. So, tingnan ninyo ito, si Peter. Hindi na siya nahihiya, hindi na siya natatakot. He has the boldness to preach people about the good news. So, yun ang transformation in Peter. They were no longer the same person. They changed from fearful to courageous men. From doubtful to strong men of faith, they began to believe God in a very personal way. Yan ninyo, the boldness of Peter and John. Kung titignan natin, si John na lang natin ang crucifixion ni Christ. Pero ngayon, kasama na niya si Peter. Kasama niya si Peter. Humaharap na sila doon sa mga high priest. May lakas na sila ng loob na humarap. The Christians want this transformation power. They can prayerfully ask God to send it to them, even though it sometimes takes a while for it to happen. Wait for it, then the sweet, wonderful feeling of the Holy Spirit comes into people's spiritual nature and make it come alive with the presence of God. Concluding statement. There are many places in the books of Acts which show the results of the disciples being transformed by the power of the Holy Spirit. They delivered powerful sermons and worked many miracles which converted many people to a salvation experience with Jesus Christ. As they did these things, the Christian church grew rapidly. Since this growth started after the coming of the Holy Spirit on Pentecost, it is considered the birthday of the Christian church. However, the great coming of the Holy Spirit was to transform the lives of the early disciples. It wasn't meant to be just for that time. Instead, the Holy Spirit has been active throughout history and is active in our modern times. This means that modern Christians have the power of the Holy Spirit to transform their life just as what has happened in the beginning of the Christian service. May we all request you to stand and pray for the infilling of the Holy Spirit. And let us dedicate this prayer to the victims of Ion typhoon in the Philippines. Holy Spirit, powerful consoler, second hand of the Father and the Son, hope the afflicted, descend into our hearts and establish in it your loving dominion. In kindred our hearts in its sorrow, the power of your love, so that we may be fully subject to you. You believe that when you dwell in us, you also dwell in the Father and the Son. Thine, therefore, come to us, consoler of the abandoned souls, protector of the needy, help the afflicted, strengthen the weak, and support the wavering. Come and purify us. Lord, move in your desire, take possession of us. You love the humble and resist the proud. Come to us, glory of the living and hope of the dying. Let us, by your grace, continue the cause of Jesus in you. Amen. Good morning, brothers and sisters. Good afternoon. Thank you.